Yes, everybody, Ross of the West Ham Network. Hope you're all safe and well. Let's predict the starting 11, shall we? Yeah, let's have a go. Now, it's worth saying it's not just match day evening for the first team, but also the under-18s. And I'm just about to hop over there to Rush Green now. It's the next round of the Premier League Invitational Cup, where West Ham take on Lyon. So we are getting your European football fix, come which way or not. And actually, incidentally, the under-21s are playing Borussia Mönchengladbach next week in the Invitational Cup. So get along to that one. There's no clash because we play on the Monday. So I'm going to miss be wishing the first half, at least. And then we'll... I might watch it on my phone next. And I'm no doubt people will ask me for updates and stuff there for the ones that are there. There'll be obviously the likes of Kenny Brown and Stevie Potts and people like that. And Kevin Keane will be there. So they'll probably be asking for what's the updates for us. So I'll probably have you on my phone. But silent, because I want to see the under-21. Six losses in a row, so hopefully they can improve and get a... Last two games in the Invitational Cup been really good. Benfica and Bilbao, both 2-2 draws, I think, when we've come back from 2-0 down. So it should be an interesting one. But let's talk the first team, shall we? And if I press the right button next time, there we go. Let's crack on. So as we always do, we'd like to give you a sort of a view of the starting 11. And I think it's going to be quite interesting to see what actually happens, in all honesty. There's so many permutations. We know from the Julian Lopetegui press conference that Jean-Claude Todibo was a doubt. We're believed to be under the illusion, the apprehension, the illusion, the news that he has not travelled. And that really he wasn't 100% for the Arsenal game at all, but apparently Mavropanos had a bout of man flu, and so he would have probably been on the bench, in all honesty. So he did well to last as long as he did against the Arsenal, to be honest. We also were under the apprehension that Niklas Füllkrug wouldn't be available. He said he wasn't too sure, and then last night we get the revelation that he's travelled. He's passed the fitness test and he's travelled. So you will see, I'm after 3 months out, he will not be starting. Spoiler alert, but I imagine he will be on the bench and actually would be good to have arguably an alternative to the striker situation, possibly. Now, what I'm going to do is go through what I think they should do. We also welcome back Mohamed Kudus as well for his 5-match suspension. Although he did play for Ghana during the international break, so it's not like he hasn't played for 6 weeks or something like that. I'm going to sort of do what I think is going to happen, what I'd like to happen, and then I'm probably going to finish with what I think will happen. Because what I think will happen, I won't enjoy it. But what I think could happen could be really exciting and a really exciting lineup, in my humble opinion. Obviously, you've got your own opinions. Let us know in the comments. Also, don't forget to comment. Comment on these videos and the review shows and watch alongs, anything like that. Every day this Advent period, we give away free stuff. We've had the first one. I'll put out probably later on today the winner of day two, and then obviously tomorrow, the winner of day three. You know how it works. It's quite simple. Also, don't forget santaco.co.uk if you want to get your little ones or your grand little ones a lovely letter from Father Christmas. My letter has turned up. You'll be pleased to know I've got a certificate. I'm on the nice list. I have handed that to Miss Budden, and she laughed in her face. Anyway, in goal, Fabianski. I don't see the reason to chop and change the goalkeeper now. You know, I think he's... Yes, he did concede 5 goals, actually, on Saturday. But I don't think, you know, the penalty wasn't really his fault. When, you know, he punched the ball and wouldn't say any of them were... I think any goalkeeper would have conceded those 5 goals. You know what I mean? 2 penalties. He almost got the second one. But I think he stays in goal. He's a bit of a calming influence. I think Ariola, I find a little bit erratic sometimes, where Fabianski's not the most dynamic goalkeeper, but he's a steady Eddie. And I think sometimes when you're in a back, you know, when you're back to the wall, you need someone who's not going to have like a I don't know, he's just going to go crazy. I think sometimes Ariola just always seems to be on the edge. I think the back four probably picks itself now with the news that Todibo didn't travel, by all accounts. So Wan-Bissaka plays right back, then Mavropanos, then Kilman, and then Emerson. He might throw a curveball and put Wan-Bissaka right back and left back and Soufal right back. He has done that occasionally. Obviously, Emerson went off after like 65 minutes, something like that, didn't he? There was reports that it looks like we're going to be offering Vladimir a contract. So obviously, he's out of contract in the summer. But we'll probably cover that in tomorrow's news. Now, I think, you know, Alvarez was back. He was on the bench. I think because we lost quite heavily, and again, I think, you know, away from home, I think he's going to maybe just tinker a little bit, and I think possibly for the better, I'll be honest, because obviously, you have to accommodate Kudus. You know, he's the best player. He's a player who's going to be always commanding two players. He hasn't played. He's going to be hungry. He's going to be wanting to, you know, when you saw the goal charts and you see Thomas Suchek is the equal top goal scorer for West Ham at the moment, you know, Kudus wants to be the man. And so it's a good opportunity to get back in, particularly they've got a very shaky defence as well. It's quite an old defence as well. You know, Connor Cody, they've got Waz, who's not the most mobile defender. And they've got the other lad as well, Vestergaard. So they're not, the central defence aren't particularly quick. And we spoke to Jack on the final whistle, Leicester fan. He was saying that James isn't playing very well. And so there's an opportunity to really go for them, particularly early on. That's what we need to do. We need to basically do what Arsenal did to us. You know, we had a bit of momentum going into the game, Newcastle games, all that, looking good. We need to go in and properly just like hit the ground running. We won't, but that's what we should do. So I think Thomas Suchek stays. I think he keeps his place. He is, you know, I think we've moved on now from Rodriguez being in the side. By all accounts, you know, January could see him go back to La Liga. Maybe not Benfica, but definitely a move out to a Spanish-based club for a nominal fee, around £2.5 million, of what we're there to be believed. And I think Alvarez comes back in. And I think, and for me, just tell Edson just to do the job and just sit in front of the back four. That's all you need. And just protect that back four. Because, you know, the trouble is we always set ourselves a goal in it because the other team always score and then we're obviously 1-0 down. So we have to score a goal to get a point. If we keep a clean sheet, we can always nick a goal. With our strike force and our forwards, we can always, it always looks like we can nick a goal. Even with 5-0 down against Arsenal, we pulled two back. And to be honest, we should have got another couple. And that was against Arsenal. Who are, you know, one of the strongest defences in the country. So that's what I think is going to happen. And then what I'd like to happen is Bowen. And again, these next four players, I'm not saying these are going to be the positions they stay in, because actually, if you watch the game, the Arsenal game, some of it was playing up front for half the game and Antonio drifted out onto the left-hand side. And I like that. I like all that movement. The only issue with that is you don't get those partnerships, those fullback winger partnerships. So when it was always Emerson and Benrahma was always a really good full, you know, and Paqueta, that was a nice partnership as well. You don't get that if you're all moving about, but you know, kind of everything in life. And then Kudus comes in at 10. And again, this is not how I think they're going to, this is how I'd like them to set up. I'm not saying this is how they're going to set up. This is how I'd like them to set up and move about. So, you know, Bowen could drift up top and whoever's playing up front could drift off to the right. And I think I would love us to, just for this game, play with a false nine. The reason why I want us to play with a false nine is because I can't see Antonio playing. We played on Saturday and he played 70 minutes, something like that, 75 minutes. Can't see him putting in a performance just from a fitness level. And so I'd rather utilise him correctly, bring him on with 25, half an hour to go, and just let him rip at them. Now, the sort of the fly in the ointment is the Nicholas Fulkrug debate. Having Nicholas now in the side does potentially mean we could have Antonio as a battering ram for half an hour, for an hour or 45 minutes, and then bring on Fulkrug. But I don't think he'll be able to last for half an hour because he hasn't played for 3 months. And then I keep Somerville on the left. I'm trying to find a way to keep Somerville because I know what's going to happen, and I'll show what I think will happen in terms of the lineup. What I'd love, that three is very fucking nice to me. And then Paqueta. He's done that quite a bit, particularly under Moyes. He played that sort of very sort of high 10, almost as a striker. But that four interchanges. So Bowen goes up top, Kudus drops to the right, and then Paqueta drops in as a 10. Sometimes Paqueta drifts out and Somerville comes in. And I like, oh, sorry, got so excited, I knocked my mic. I like that dynamic. The only issue is you don't have haven't got a target man, which means the out ball, the easy out ball from Fabianski just down the line to Antonio to run. You don't do that, but you've got the channels. So you could put the balls over the top for Bowen to run onto, or for get those fullbacks and get those two sort of slurry centre halves turning, and we will batter them with pace. We really will. Now, what I think is going to happen is this. This is what I'd like to happen. And that to me is quite a brave decision to do that. Because in essence, you're going with four forwards. A bit like anyone saw Brentford the other day. They always played 4-2-4. And they absolutely took Leicester. And this was the same side they're playing Leicester now. They were brilliant. And I'd love us to be able to do that. And we have the players to do that. I think we're going to that. And I'm gutted if that's the way, because I think Somerville's been playing really well. Not set the world alight, but he's been playing really well, you know, as well as anyone else on the side. He doesn't deserve to be dropped just because Kudus is back. The other option could be dropping Paqueta and bringing in Kudus either as a 10, because he's wasting the left-hand side. The other option is Souček has a rest. And with Paqueta plays a 10, plays sort of the 8 role, which he's been doing with Soler. I just think Soler was taken off. The other sort of thought in my head is Soler for Alvarez. You know, the fact is he took off Soler and Paqueta at the same time, which to me suggests he was resting them and bringing on like Yedo Rodriguez and Andy Irvine and stuff like that. So, I mean, there's a dozen ways. There's a dozen ways. I don't think it'll be a back three. That's one thing I think it won't be. So Cresswell comes in and plays a back three. That's one thing I don't think it'll be, because we haven't got that third recognised centre half. Yes, we could put Cresswell in. Yes, we could put Kaelin Casey in. Yes, we could put, I mean, Ezra was on the bench, a sort of a late call up for the Arsenal game. But I think that is what's going to happen. Am I happy that's what's going to happen? I'm happy that Kudus is on the pitch, but I'm not happy in the position he's in, if that's what we'll see. But again, we'll wait and see. In an hour or so's time, hour and a half's time, we'll see the starting 11 and see how close we are to it. But what I'd like you to do, and also by doing it, you enter into the giveaway, the old winter Christmas giveaway, is comment your starting 11. What's your starting 11? Does, in your opinion, does Kudus start straight away or is he on the bench? For me, I just think I think Lopetegui can't afford to start him on the bench, in honesty. This is a crunch game. I know we've been saying that for a while, but this one is. Particularly the Newcastle game, maybe a bit of stay of execution, possibly. The Arsenal game, there was a lot of criticism coming from the board, by what we've been led to be believed, what we've read, that they were very disappointed with just the contrast, the difference in terms of the performance, despite the fact it was the same side. That, to me, showed a little bit of naivety, I thought, because I think sometimes you do need to tinker with a side to match the opposition you're playing with. And it shows you're not pig-headed. It shows you're adaptable. And it was a bit... I personally would have started Alvarez and maybe given Paqueta or maybe given Soler. Some people didn't agree. Some people were happy that it was the same side. But I just thought, particularly against Arsenal, particularly that midfield of Odegaard and Rice, you know, it was easy to bulldoze them in terms of, you know, just that extra bit of bite in the midfield. But that's just me. Yeah, as I said, I'm going to be at the Rush Green in a little bit for the Premier League Invitational Cup next round or next game. Group game thing, I don't really know how it works, with Olympique Lyon, Libanais Lyon. So I'm looking forward to that. And keep an eye on the channel for anything. The watch show, we might be delayed if we have it, but we'll definitely try and have the review show afterwards and then the fallout. But as I said, I think this game is critical for Lopetegui. I think if a loss today, I think it could be curtains just because of, you know, the fact is we're going into a period where we've got Wolves next week. And then after Wolves, is it Bournemouth and Brighton? And then Southampton. So we should be picking up points then. And a bit like what Leicester have done, they decided to change management before it was too late, before they had to bring in a firefighter. That's what I don't want us to get to. If we're sticking with Lopetegui, we stick with him. Lots of reports today about Sergio Conceição, who apparently is, according to Jacob Steinberg, who we know who Jacob Steinberg's sources are, is apparently being favoured. We also heard that Erling Tesic is still there. And so It needs sorting. And that's it, my friends. Thank you very, very much for your time, as per usual. Don't forget, if you want to get your child a little thing, a Father Christmas letter. Oh, I've left it up in the garage. Maybe I'll show you tomorrow, or I'll show you Thursday, definitely, the letter. Very, very easy to do with our friends at santaco.co.uk. And I'll just play a little bit of a video just to give you an idea of what it's all about. With Christmas just around the corner, make sure your little ones or your grand little ones have got their letter from Father Christmas, personalised letter through the post. With our friends at Santa Co., very easy, intuitive website lets you put in your specific details for your little ones and get a personalized letter sent out by the big man. So this is how it works. You enter your child's name into the software, whether they're male, female, whether they've got any siblings, their siblings' names, what they've achieved over that year, whether they've been misbehaving. You can put that information in, and there's clear examples. Names of any friends, any notable experiences in the past year where Santa's going to be visiting on Christmas Eve, any lessons they want to learn, be careful what you wish for. And then it goes and writes the letter, all personalised to those information points you put in. So you'll see stuff like the 26,000 subscribers. You've got things like the Open Conference win, the fact I've been eating a pizza, be careful what I wish for, my trip holiday to Dubai. All those things have been entered in to help personalize the letter to the young one. And once you're happy with that, you can obviously edit that. You can make your own adjustments to that letter before you hit proceed. But once you're happy with that, you press ready to go. You put in your bank details and it'll be sent out by Royal Mail very, very, very quickly. You can pay for 1 day or 3 day. So really easy to do. That's santaco.co.uk. Get involved and make sure your little ones have a Christmas to remember.